Hey everyone, welcome to the Stories of Language Learners. I am your host, Charles. In today's episode, I talked with Camylla from the beautiful city of Rio. She is an English teacher who has been helping dozens of students, and she's super passionate about learning languages. In this episode, she shared with us her journey of learning English. She shared a lot of awesome resources that she has been using to learn. Also, if you are a shy person who struggles sometimes to practice your speaking, you definitely don't want to miss this episode because we talked a lot about it. I really enjoyed our conversation. We had a great time and I'm sure that you are gonna enjoy it as well. Welcome to the Stories of Language Learners. Today I have a special guest with me, my dear friend Camylla from Rio. So how are you, Camylla?
Hey, Charles. Thank you so much for inviting me. I'm really glad to be here and I'm doing really great. And I hope that everybody's doing great as well.
Yeah, we are living a crazy time right now where everyone are in their homes. So I hope that things can get better. Okay, do you remember when we met?
Yes. We met in July of last year. We were participating in a challenge about fluency, you know, talking to people, you know, reaching people to have conversations in English. And that's when we met, July of last year.
Yeah, for those of you who don't know, I recorded, I think, the second episode of this podcast. You guys can check it out about the Fluency Breakthrough Challenge, which is a challenge that we did together on Instagram. And yeah, that was awesome. And I think you are the number one person that I always talked with. We kept in touch, which is very cool. Not just you, but I met a lot of amazing and super good people through this experience. So I'm so glad that you are here because this podcast is about learning language. So, and I know that you like to learn language and we both are English learners. So I already told my story about my whole journey of learning English in the first episode or in the second episode. I think it was in the second episode. And today I would love to hear, Camylla, your learning journey. So when did you start to learn English?
So I started learning English in 2014. At the beginning, it wasn't something that I was like really, that was really caring about, you know. I was just like, oh, you know, English is necessary, you know, for job interviews and everything. So I'm going to join English course. So I joined the English course in 2014. And at the beginning, it was just normal learning. You know, I would go to the classes, go back home, just open my book again in the next class. And it was going like this. And then, you know, I was enjoying more and more the classes and the language. And there was a day that I was like, you know, it's really interesting, you know, this English learning, this language learning. I'm gonna search for some YouTube videos here, and I found some amazing YouTube channels, and I started watching a lot of videos, like one and another one and then another one, another one, and then I got addicted to watching grammar videos. And you know, after this, I think it was in 2015, you know, that when I really started studying English. So, but I say that I started in 2014 because it was the point that I joined the English course. And so it was like this, you know, in 2014, I fell in love with the language. And then, you know, until today, I'm an English teacher. I never thought that I would be an English teacher when I started learning back in 2014. You know, it's amazing when you fall in love with something like this, you know, learning a language. And this was my case, you know, after 2015, I fell in love with English and we have a really amazing relationship.
I remember that when I saw you for the first time in the Fluency Breakthrough Challenge, I thought, man, she writes so well and she also speaks so well. What she's doing in the Fluency Breakthrough Challenge? And I can see that you are really passionate about learning English. And also, you know another language that you are starting to learn or you think about start learning?
I started learning Spanish. It's really nice because, you know, it's really similar to to Portuguese. That is my native language, Brazilian Portuguese. It's really similar, and it has been really nice. I could, with this English learning process, I could see that I not only enjoy learning English, that I enjoy learning language as a whole, you know. So like now I'm learning Spanish, and I have a goal that I want to speak at least 5 different languages. I already speak 2, my native language and English, and you know, I'm getting there with my Spanish, and after Spanish, I hope that I can, that I'm able to learn French and German.
Oh, that's awesome. Another thing that I would like to talk about it is, for example, here in Brazil, I think it's very common, because you started to learn, you really, for what I understood, started to invest your time to learn English when you started to do a course. But before that, all of us here in Brazil, we have English classes in school. And let me ask you, did you learn in school the verb to be?
Yeah, I don't know how many times I learned verb to be. I think I went from like middle school to high school studying verb to be, like semester after semester, you know, just learning verb to be. Mm-hmm. And you know, it's crazy. I don't know why this happens in Brazil, but we have these English classes at school that normally we just learn about verb to be. Mm-hmm. And pronouns and subject pronouns, you know, just like simple stuff. I don't remember learning something like present perfect, maybe on my school, you know, and on my classes at school. I was just learning, you know, the same thing, learning, you know, reviewing the same thing, you know, semester by semester. Every year I was like verb to be, and you know, the same stuff, colors, animals, you know, basic stuff that they would teach us every year.
Yeah, for those of you that are not familiar with that, so if you are not from Brazil, I asked her about it because this is kind of an inside joke. For example, I always studied in public school, so for me it was the same when I was in school or when I was in high school. The only thing that I remember that I learned was the verb to be, because I would learn about it over and over again. And yeah, it's kind of sad because we don't usually have speaking classes, right? And we just learn grammar and stuff like that. So here in Brazil, if you want to continue to invest in your learning journey with English, you need to go to schools. But did you have a great experience in the school that you did that course?
Yes, it was really nice. When I first joined, I fell in love with the institution as well. No, the teachers, they were amazing. The whole English course was amazing, from the secretaries to the teachers. They were amazing. And, you know, it was a really nice experience. And I think that I just fell in love with English thanks to my teachers, you know, because they made me see the nice point of English, the nice way of learning a language. So it was a really nice experience. It was really interesting. And it's like you said, in Brazil, unfortunately, we don't have really good English classes at schools. So if you want to keep learning and improve your English learning, you need to study by yourself, you know, with YouTube video or something like this, or do the same as I did, you know, join an English course, take an English course. But it was really nice, you know, it was an amazing course. And always when someone asks me like, when did you take your English course? I always say the name of the course, and I say like, I highly recommend them. They are amazing.
What is the name of this school? Let's talk about it, because
yeah.
I think people,
it's
from
CNA.
Rio. Oh, CNA. Okay.
Awesome. It's a huge brand, I think. I think they have schools on other states as well. CNA, it's amazing. You know, it's one of the best English courses that I have ever seen.
And for how long did you do that course?
5 years. It was a long time. You know, I would say that it was like my second home, you know, because every week I was there, every Friday or Saturday I was there, you know, having classes, talking to my classmates. So it was like my second home. You know, I spent like 5 years of my life going there every week, seeing seeing the same people, talking to the same people. So they were like my second house and my family.
One of the things that I remember when we first start to talk through the Fluency Breakthrough Challenge is that we have a lot of things in common. First of all, every time that we start to talk, we always have good information to share with each other. But one thing that I wrote here that I would like to discuss, it is that we both are kind of shy person. And I think that a lot of people feel the same way. There are a lot of shy person out there who sometimes struggle to learn a new language. I was one of them because I started to study for real English in 2015 when I started doing a course. But I avoided for so long to start to speak because I was so afraid to step out of my comfort zone. I was worrying about what people would think about my pronunciation. I was waiting for my English to be perfect, which it's never gonna happen. And that's okay. I think that our goal should be to be able to connect and communicate with people. So as a shy person, what do you think that helps you the most to overcome this shyness to start to speak another language?
I think people are not gonna believe that we are shy, but we are. Yeah. please believe us. When I started learning, I would do something like this, you know, which would be impossible for me, you know, to be here talking to you, recording this podcast, you know, which would be really impossible for me. During my classes in English course, I remember that I used to avoid speaking. I was like, no. We always had conversation practice, and I would speak like in a very low volume, like nobody's gonna listen to me because I don't want people judging me. Like the same thing that you said, you know, judging my pronunciation, judging my grammar, and, you know, judging me as a whole. And, you know, I think what helped me to overcome this was that I found friends to talk to, you know, like, as I told you already, like in the English course, they were like my family. So I got really used to them. And there was a moment that I was talking to myself, like, I don't need to be afraid of these people. You know, they are my friends. They are like my family. We know each other for like a long time. We are learning together for years. So I started talking to them. You know, we started having some more conversation practice, you know, besides the classes that we had. We used to stay a little more time after the class just to have a little conversation practice. And I think that, you know, people that is shy as we are, they could try to find friends to talk to, you know. And I think that also what helped me a lot was the Fluency Breakthrough Challenge. Before that, I couldn't speak to strangers like this, you know. I couldn't record videos, and I'm still shy. When I post a video on my Instagram, I'm shy. I'm like, oh my gosh, people are gonna watch this video and, you know, judge me maybe. But I think, like, you know, that doesn't matter anymore. You know, I'm doing what I like. I'm speaking English. I'm posting my videos. People are commenting, and I feel really, really happy when I see people commenting my videos, you know, and, you know, telling me like, oh, good job, amazing. So I think we need to push ourselves out of our comfort zone. I know that's difficult, you know. I am really shy. I'm still a really shy person. But, you know, we need to force ourselves out of our comfort zone, you know. And, you know, we can try to do this with friends, you know. Find a friend that maybe you can have an English conversation with them, or Spanish conversation, or any language that you are learning. And, you know, try to do this, you know. You have to force yourself.
Yeah, I remember the first call that I did through the Fluency Breakthrough Challenge. I was so terrified because I didn't know what to expect. Actually, the first call that I did only a voice call because I was too worried about using the video and the call. I was so nervous. But after I did my first call, things started to get easier and easier. So if you want to improve your speaking skills, there is no other way. You need to step out of your comfort zone. You need to try to speak with people. And right now, we live in a days where everything is online, so you can find people online. You can start to use social media strategically. You can try to follow people who speak, who write in English. You can try to interact with them. And yeah, that's the power of the internet. Without the internet, we wouldn't be having this conversation right now.
Exactly.
So I would like to ask you a little bit, for example, after you graduated from this English school, for you to continue to learn this language, what tools do you started to use? For example, YouTube channels or social media pages or apps, something like that, that you could share with us?
As I said, I started watching a lot of YouTube videos. And besides the YouTube videos, I would use flashcards. Do you know flashcards like Anki or there's another one, I think, is something with G. I don't remember the name. Mm-hmm. But they are flashcards, you know, any app that you can create flashcards. Oh, the other one that I used to use is Quizlet. It's the same as Anki. I think it's interesting when you use flashcards because they give you like a space, you know, like last week I reviewed these thing, so like next week I'll have to record, we'll have to review this again. So I think it's nice flashcards because they kind of stuck in your mind, you know, you, and when you see something you say like, oh, I have studied this in that flashcard, you know, I use this and it's really nice. So I used to use this one. There's I think you could say that is an app called Grammarly that helps us with our writing, you know, it corrects our writing, these basic mistakes that we can do like with prepositions and some basic grammar mistakes. I really like this one. You know, there's a cell phone app and also computer app. And there's another website that is also really interesting. I found this too. I was like searching for tools to continue, you know, to continue improving my English. And I found one that it's really nice. It's Engvid. Is when you can find lots of grammar videos. And there's another one that it's amazing. The name is Youglish. Like Youglish. You can, it's about pronunciation, you know. You put the word there, for example, nature. And you're gonna find like lots of videos with people talking that same word. You know, it's amazing because you can practice your pronunciation with American accent, British accent, Aussie accent. You know, it's amazing. It's really, really interesting. And another one that I also use that I think it's really nice, even more when you are writing, the name is Thesaurus. If you want to, you can check on YouTube, on Google. It's a dictionary for synonyms of words, you know. So for example, if you don't want to keep repeating the same word again and again and again, you can search, you know, you can type the word that you are saying, and you can and they give you like lots of synonyms to use. So I started using this one, these apps and these websites, and they really helped me to, you know, keep improving my English.
Thank you so much for sharing. I really appreciate. And also I learned a lot. There are a lot of tools that I didn't know about, so I'm excited to learn more about them. And for you guys that are listening to it, I will include in the show notes all these resources so you guys can check it out as well. So nowadays, let's talk a little bit. You are an English teacher, and how often, besides doing classes, you try to practice your English or maybe another language, let's say in a week?
I practice my English every day. As I said, like, it's my passion. So for me, it's, I don't know, it's like a hobby. It's the time that I forget about everything and I just think about English and, you know, finding nice things in English. So I would say that per day, I practice English for like 4 hours, between 4 and 5 hours per day. And I have 1 hour for practicing my Spanish. So I would say like for, in my day for language learning, I practice between 5 and 6 hours. So it's really nice that I find interesting. I don't feel like something difficult, like, oh my gosh, I have to practice my English, I have to practice my Spanish. No, it's something that it's interesting. You know, when I'm stressed, I feel like, you know, I'm going to practice some English, I'm going to practice some Spanish. You know, it's really nice when you enjoy the learning process. Mm-hmm. I think this makes you improve even faster because you enjoy, so you don't feel like, you don't feel bored about studying. So I would say that, like, nowadays I practice language learning between English and Spanish 5 to 6 hours a day.
That's awesome. And something that I always say to people is that learning a new language doesn't need to be boring. because I know that a lot of people, they feel discouraged to learn because they think, oh man, now I need to learn grammar, I need to do this exercise. One of the things that I really believe in is like to try to immerse yourself in the language. So for example, if you are a person who is passionate about photography, you should try to learn things about photography in English. You should try to watch videos or listening to podcasts about photography in English. So that really helps you to keep motivated to learn and not give up. Okay, I have two final questions. The number one is, do you think that it is important to learn a second language and why?
Yes, I think it's really, really, really important, not just thinking about job opportunities, not thinking about job career or something like this. Because I think when you learn a second language, you learn about the culture of that country. And, you know, with this, when you learn the culture of the country, I think you open your mind to the world, you know, and it's also possible, like with English, the world is happening in English. You have the news first in English, and then you have translated to your language. You have movies first in English and then translated to your language. So like talking about English mainly now, you can see things first. You can find really, really amazing resources and everything on internet with English. You know, there's lots of free stuff on internet in English. It's like you said, if you like photography, you can learn about photography in English. And you can find this for free. So I think that it's really important when you learn a second language because of this and because of also what I have said. You learn about a different culture. So it's like you open your mind and maybe your heart as well. You know, you open yourself for the world, you know, for understanding the differences. You know, I think this is one of the most amazing parts of learning a language. You understand the differences, you know, that people are different, that, you know, cultures are different. That's why I think learning languages, it's really important.
Yeah, once I heard about one expression or a phrase that it's like when you speak in a foreign language, you are speaking with the heart of that person who speaks that language as their native language. And this is something really incredible. And just the fact that you are able to communicate with people from so many different backgrounds and cultures and learning more about these kind of lives that people live in other countries, it's very nice.
Yeah.
So, okay, the last question. If someone is thinking about learning English today, what is the number one thing that this person should do to start learning? I know that a lot of people that they are listening to us right now, they probably already are able to understand because they have good listening skills. But thinking about this question, what these people can do to continue to improve their English in general, but especially in speaking?
I would say, like, if you want to, like, really start speaking, it's like you said, Charles, you need to immerse yourself on the language, like, watch movies in English, watch TV series in English, listen to music in English, read in English, write in English, talk to yourself in English. I used to do this, I still do this a lot, you know, I talk to myself in English every time. Like, you are thinking about the things you have to do. Like, oh, today I need to wash the dishes. I need to do that. Take my dog for a walk. Do that and that. Try, instead of thinking about this in your native language, think in English, you know. Talk to yourself in English. When you are alone and you are talking to yourself, you know, speak in English. And then after this, you can do some maybe shadowing technique as well, some shadowing practice. Shadowing practice, for those of you who maybe don't know what this is when you listen to, for example, a sentence and you pause the video or the movie or the TV series that you are watching and you repeat everything. And then you listen to that sentence again and try to speak at the same time, so that you see if you are pronouncing the words correctly, if you are using the same intonation maybe. So like, for when you want to, like, improve your speaking, I think this is the best way of doing this, you know, shadowing techniques, shadowing practice, and also immerse yourself on the language, you know, and also talk to yourself in English. It's really interesting and it's really important because you can catch your mistakes. Something that is also really nice to do is recording your voice or recording yourself speaking English and then watch it, because when you watch it, you can catch your mistakes and you can say like, oh, I made a mistake when I was talking about this. And probably you're never gonna make that mistake again, because always when you, you know, you're almost making that mistake and you remember at that, you know, of that time that you recorded yourself and you saw that mistake and you say like, no, I'm not gonna make this mistake again. You know, you're gonna remember this because we also have these, our minds, they work like with memories, you know, so it's like vocabulary. If you grab a vocabulary and you link that vocabulary with a picture of something or with someone, you're not gonna forget this vocabulary anymore. So it's the same with speaking. If you record yourself or record your voice, you can listen to this after and you're gonna catch your mistakes. So you are not gonna make that mistakes again, because you will remember when you are speaking, you will remember that you were making that mistakes and it's not gonna happen anymore.
I truly believe that it's very powerful when you record yourself, because I've been recording this podcast and I listen to it a lot, and I realized, I'm not sounding like I should be sounding. I need to work in this mistake or try to improve in this area, because I am auto-correcting myself. And also about shadowing, something that I started to try doing. So for you guys that are listening to it, you can choose, for example, someone that you think that they have a really nice speaking skill, that they are very clear, and if you want to sound like them, you should start shadowing. And I think that this really can improve your speaking skills. So yeah, I think that is it. This was the whole questions that I have to you. I think that we had a great conversation. I hope that this can be helpful for those out there that are listening to us right now. Thank you so much, Camylla, for your time. It's always great to talk with you. Where can people find you online?
Oh, so you can find me on Instagram. My account is at CamyXXY. So it's like CamyXX1, number one. You can find me there. You know, you're going to see, like, there's lots of videos. So probably when you find me, you can watch my videos as well. And I also give online classes for conversational classes and also grammar classes. If you need, you know, I give all of the kinds of classes, grammar classes, conversation practice classes. So if you want to have a class with me, you can find me on Instagram and you can send me a message there. I answer everyone. I'm always looking for new messages, and you can find me there and send me a message.
Okay, again, thank you so much for being here, and I'll see you around. Bye bye.
Thank you so much. Bye bye.
Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode. I hope you learned something. If you liked this podcast, please share it with your friends. I would love to hear your feedback about the show. Your feedback is super important for me. Please send me a message on Instagram. Also, I created a community on Telegram. In this group, I encourage people to help each other to learn and practice English together, and besides that, we are doing monthly video calls. Feel free to join us. I will include links of all the resources that we mentioned in the show notes, including where you can find me online. And yeah, that's it. Thank you so much for listening, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye.